What's good, people? You're tuned into Colours, City of Liverpool, online radio station. My name's Rosie Rothschild. I've got my guy with me, goes by the name of Levi.
Levi Tafari.
There we go, he's finished it off for me, yes. So my guy, he's big in the game, in the dub policy game. So we're just going to ask him a couple of questions. Obviously, why he's at Lymph, is he enjoying himself? And obviously get him to do a little bit of a rendition of some of his best work. Okay, so obviously, can I start with, why are you at Lymph?
Yeah, here to support the event,
yeah.
And love music, different genres of music. And my son, DJ Zeke, was performing here today, so...
I've just met Zeke for the first time.
Yeah, Zeke, man, top DJ, you know. Different styles.
Yeah.
But yeah, so here to enjoy and support the event from Liverpool, artists here in Liverpool, and, you know, these things need to be supported, because if people don't turn out, then they'll stop events like this. So yeah, here for the music and the culture.
Little bit off wing, what's your opinion on the barricade outside, big green walls?
Well, the thing is, what they could have done was maybe put mesh so people could see through. If they're going to charge people, then they need some kind of barrier to stop people walking in. And for it's only a fiver, which isn't a great deal of money for a festival like this, you know. You go to some of the other festivals around the country, and you're talking £100 and you're not getting the same artists or just as good an artist.
Yeah. Have you seen all the ranting online, though?
Yeah, people love to complain, and it was free for a long time, and things change, man. The whole dynamic of politics and social living and culture is changing. So we're dealing in a technological world where the dynamics of that makes people think different and act different.
Yeah. These are actually quite good answers, by the way.
You mean intelligent dread, man. Intelligence.
We'll get back on, right?
Yeah.
So, other than obviously coming to support the festival and your son, is there any acts that you've thought, I need to go and see that act?
Yeah, man. Jazzy B performed yesterday.
Yeah.
Nice. Shauna B. And... tonight Jazzy Jeff is playing, Westwood is playing.
Old school,
so, yeah, man. Yeah. And it's sounds I can relate to, you know, because we come up through reggae, soul, hip-hop, you know, rap, all of those things was bubbling and we support them. And as a person who is creative, I decided to try my own thing. And it's worked out well because I travel all over the world and...
You said before you was a guest in Gambia.
Yeah, went to Gambia with Madeline Hennigan, who's one of the directors of Writing on the Wall. And we wanted to do some research into the griot tradition, which is responsible for some of the things you're seeing here today. Rap, you know, dancehall, toasting, DJing, you know, spitting lyrics, spoken word come from the griot. And they had a tradition in West Africa of playing the kora, which is a 21-string instrument, and drums. And then they would chant, they would document what was happening historically, culturally, socially, politically within their vicinity. And they were nomadic. They would move from village to village, retaining the history and perpetuating the culture and developing new styles.
I heard that when you went, they treated you like royalty.
Yeah, because while we were there, the British ambassador to Gambia heard Madeline and I was there, and she invited us to the embassy, and she put on a cultural extravaganza in our honour. Yeah. And then I did a performance for some of the performers there. And since I've returned to the UK, we've kept in touch via social media. So we're looking to go back again, hopefully, you know, sometime in November, because they've invited us again.
Well, it sounds amazing to me, mate.
Nice one, man.
It sounds like a full-on adventure.
It's
a journey.
No, man, I've been writing and performing since 1977. Well, I started writing in 77 and started performing around 1981. So and since then, and I studied classical French cuisine.
So I was a chef in between. Years?
No. You're putting years on it. No, man, it's about 40 years.
Yeah. So, still an achievement in itself, though.
Yeah, man, yeah, and I'm still going, and I've got a couple of big projects coming up in Liverpool that I'm going to work with different communities alongside Nina Edge, who's a visual artist and designer. So, yeah, look out for that, man. I won't give too much away.
Too much, but look
in case somebody take the idea, you know what I mean? But
while we've got you here, right, can we have a little exclusive for Colours rendition of something that you've got in the band?
So this one is called Streets of Hope, because we're here in Liverpool. And Liverpool is a city that is resilient, man. It gets knocked down and it gets up again, reinvents itself. And we have two cathedrals at either end of Hope Street. So the whole idea of hope and, you know, we walk with hope in our heart. So this one's called Streets of Hope. Stereotypes and media hypes, the victim Liverpool. They painted a picture of a criminal culture, uncouth and very, very cruel. In vibrant times, poets would rhyme, comedians carried the swing. There was Mersey Beat, the vibe out on the street, and everybody wanted to sing. You never walk alone in my Liverpool home. LFC wore the colours of success. They would beat teams up while retaining the cup. Teams that visited left distressed. Check out the TV soap. Visit the Streets of Hope with two cathedrals shrouded in fame. Newspapers from the gutter distorted our disaster, and Liverpool was back in the frame. Now some people say they love the accent, but then they pass judgment. They say Scousers are always on the rob. Well, there's a Scouser in town, so screw everything down. That's why Scousers just can't get a job. Well, there's the Albert Docks and the Live O'Clocks. Sail the ferry across the Mersey. Check out the famous skyline, which is recognized every time, with the image that is oh so chirpy. But she is known worldwide, this daughter of Merseyside, with a passion that burns like fire. So the reason I write is to shed forth some light. And Liverpool, you never fail to inspire.
Jesus Christ. Yes.
You know what I mean? So, is that what we're dealing with?
I can honestly say right now, I genuinely feel inspired. I'm a rap artist myself, and I just got inspired there right now. So, I hope you feel the way I felt there. Do subscribe to the channel. Big massive shout out to my guy, Levi, for coming on.
Showrunners Radio, at the heart of the community.
I did it. Well, I've got a Liverpool poem I could do.
Yeah?
Yeah, Streets of Hope.
Let's do it. That's quite close now, it's all right.
Yeah.
Okay, so... I did three.